Today, my topic is Tennessee Williams' drama, A Streetcar Named Desire. In my previous session, we discussed about Tennessee Williams and scene 1 story. Today, scene 2. So, in this scene, Stella is going to inform about the loss of Belle Reve to Stanley. It is 6 o'clock the following evening. Blanche is taking bath and Blanche's dress, a flowered print, is laid out on Stella's bed. Stanley enters the kitchen from outside. The sound of the perpetual blue piano floats in from the street corner. When Stanley objects to Blanche's dress being laid out on Stella's bed, Stella cools him. She then informs him that she is taking Blanche out for supper at restaurant and then to show because it is a poker night. When he asks about his own supper, Stella tells him that she has kept cold meat in the refrigerator. She tells him that she is trying to keep Blanche out till the poker party disbands because she is not sure how Blanche would view Stanley and his friends playing poker with a lot of noise and drinks. So she asked him some money for their expenses out of home. Stanley inquires where Blanche is and Stella says that she is bathing in a hot tub to soothe her nerves for she is terribly upset. When Stanley asks Stella over what Blanche is upset and Stella opens the subject of the loss of the ancestral home of the Du Boises slowly. She informs him that despite the Herculean efforts, here Hercules, the great Greek warrior, so that type of efforts made by Blanche, so she said Herculean efforts of Blanche to hold their ancestral home, but it had slipped through her fingers. So Blanche is very much upset and nerve-broken about it. This is not the time for Stanley to open up the topic with Blanche and he had better to wait till she regains her mental position. It would be better if he says something nice about her appearance. He must try to understand her condition and feelings and not hurt her. During this time, the song sung by Blanche from the bathroom reveals her real predicament. Stanley does not like to treat the matter of the loss of Belle Reve by Blanche so lightly. He wants to know more from Stella about it. He feels that Blanche has fondled her sister Stella. He wants to know from Stella whether Blanche had shown her any sale deed or any papers, that is documents, relating to Belle Reve. He asserts his right over his wife's property by quoting the Napoleonic Code which is in operation in the state of Louisiana. He tells Stella that he will not let Blanche cheat him and Stella of their legitimate rights to Belle Reve. Stella tells him that Belle Reve does not seem to have been sold. At this, Stanley asks her angrily if it was then given away in charity. Stella tries to calm him down for fear of Blanche hearing him. But Stanley says that he is not bothered if Blanche hears him. He shouts at Stella and says that he is not bothered for anything, that he wants to see the papers connected with the holding Belrive. Stella feels that Stanley is making himself ridiculous by suspecting Blanche of cheating them. Stanley then asks Stella angrily if Blanche is not cheating them, where did the money arising from the sale of Belrive go? At this, Stella tells him that Belrive was not at all sold, but it was lost. In spite of the protest of Stella, he pulls out the trunk of Blanche and ransacks her dress by opening it, pointing out the armful of dress, and he asks how Blanche could have bought those expensive items of clothes out of her paltry, that is very meager, pay as a teacher. He then points out to other pieces of finery such as gold bracelets and pearls to Stella as a proof. He feels that the Blanche has equipped herself with rich clothes and ornaments out of the money she got by selling Belrive. Then Stella becomes very angry with Stanley and asks him not to behave like a stupid and horrid creature and better close the trunk of Blanche. Stanley cannot put up with Stella ordering him like this and in his distraught temper kicks the trunk partly closed. And he then sits on the kitchen table. Stella then picks up her white hat and gloves and asks Stanley to come out with her while Blanche is getting dressed. But Stanley says that he would not take orders from Stella and would stay there itself. When Stella asks him if he intends to insult Blanche by doing so, he replies that he is going to demand Blanche to show him the papers connected with Belrive. So now the clash between Blanche and Stanley. Disappointed and angry with Stanley, Stella goes out on the porch. And Blanche comes out of the bathroom in a red satin robe. She tries to please Stanley by drawing his attention to her beautiful personality. So here we come to know the character of Blanche. And she tells him that she is all freshly bathed and scented and feeling a brand new human being. Without minding her words, Stanley lights a cigarette. She then tells Stanley that she understands that there is going to be a little card party to which ladies are not invited. Stanley says that it is so, knowing from Stanley that Stella is on the porch. All on a sudden, Blanche notices that the trunk is left half open with the dress items thirsting outside. She asks Stanley who has rifled her trunk. Stanley says that Stella and he were helping her unpack. Stanley at this says that Blanche seems to have raided some stylish shops in Paris. Not knowing the sarcastic touch of the query, she replies that clothes are her obsession. When Stanley wants to know the cost of fur pieces that she has, Blanche tells him that they were all a tribute to her beauty for an admirer of hers. Stanley mischievously observes that the admirer must have had a lot of admiration for her. In the meantime, Stella calls Stanley to come out and let Blanche finish dressing. But Blanche informs Stella that she is already through it. At this, Stella asks her to come out then. Blanche asks Stella to do the favor of going up to a drugstore and get her a lemon coke. Stella offers to comply. Then she asks Stanley to avoid double talk and ask her whatever he wants to ask straight away. She has nothing to hide whatsoever. Stanley then demands of her the papers connected with Belrive. Blanche takes a tin box out of her trunk and hands it over to him, saying that it contains all the legal papers relating to Belrive. But before giving him the box, she picks out some love letters out of it, which she treasures. Stanley rudely snatches them from her, thinking that she is withholding vital documents from him. In the scuffle, the letters fall on the ground and Blanche feels hurt and insulted, and she says that she would burn the letters as his touch had defiled them. She then puts on spectacles and separates the paper relating to Belrive. She hands over all of them to Stanley and asks him to do whatever he likes with them. Stanley becomes somewhat cowed down and says that he has to protect the interest of both Stella and himself, as they are going to have their baby soon. On hearing that Stella is going to have her baby soon, Blanche jumps out and rushes to Stella, who has just returned from the drugstore. She congratulates Stella by calling her Star. So yes, Stella means star. And Blanche embraces Stella warmly and congratulates her affectionately. She tells Stella that she has tackled the situation with Stanley very nicely. And Stella apologizes on behalf of Stanley for having hurt and insulted her sister. Blanche says that they had now to adjust with persons like Stanley and mix with them, as they have lost Belrive. So overall, in this scene, much against the advice of Stella, Stanley begins to ransack Blanche's trunk. When Blanche comes out of the bathroom, he rudely questions her about the loss of Belrive and demands the papers related to the property. He does not hesitate even to pull out her love letters. He tells her that he has to safeguard his interest, as Stella is going to have their baby. And Blanche asks Stanley to help her fasten the back button of her gown, but Stanley does not fall for her tricks and tells Blanche remark that Stanley lacks taste. And Stanley says that he is not one who admires so-called glamour. Now, scene 3, the poker night of Stanley, Steve, Mitch and Pablo in Stanley's apartment. The poker players wear colored shirts, solid blues, a purple, a red and white check, a light green, and they are men at the peak of their physical manhood, as coarse and direct and powerful as the primary colors. There are vivid slices of watermelon on the table, whiskey bottles and glasses. The bedroom is comparatively dim, with only the light that spills between the door curtains and through the wide window on the street. So the third scene's setting mentioned by Tennessee William. Here the poker game is on. On the same night, Stanley, Steve, Mitch and Pablo are playing poker in the kitchen of Stanley's apartment. The game proceeds noisily amidst swearings, drinking whiskey and eating watermelons. Stanley has been losing and therefore not in a good mood. Added to this, he has consumed a lot of whiskey, and Mitch is obviously not showing much interest in the game, as he is disturbed by the thought of a sick and ailing mother at home. Stanley then shouts at Mitch, saying that he should have remained at home in that case. When Mitch regrets what he would do after the death of his mother, here Stanley mocks at him, saying that he will fix up a nice girl for him to marry. And after hearing this mock from Stanley, Mitch moved from the place with tears. So in that next part, that Blanche is introduced to the players, that is poker players, by Stella. It is 2:30 a.m. Stella and Blanche appear around the corner of the building. Stella guesses that the poker game is still on. Desirous of impressing Stanley and his friends, Blanche asks Stella if she looks all right. Stella assures her sister that she does look very lovely, but Blanche tells Stella that she feels very hot and exhausted. She powders herself and then they enter. Stanley inquires of Stella where they had been, and she tells him that she and Blanche had been to a show, and after this Stella straightaway introduces Blanche to the players except Mitch, who is in the bathroom. Then she asks her husband how long will the game go. He tells her that it will go until they get ready to quit. Blanche tells Stanley that poker is very fascinating and wants to know if she could stay and watch the game. Stanley replies in the negative and desires that Stella and Blanche had better go up and sit with Eunice. Blanche wants to take a bath as she finds her nerves strung. She knocks at the bathroom door. Mitch opens the door and comes out. At this, Stella introduces Mitch to Blanche. Then she asks Mitch about the condition of his mother's health. Mitch tells her that her condition remains the same, and he thanks Stella for sending custard to his mother. As he proceeds to the kitchen, he steals a glance at Blanche. And Blanche also takes a keen interest on Mitch and asks a lot of questions about him to Stella. Stella tells her sister that Mitch is not married and he is working on the precision bench in the spare parts department of the plant where Stanley works as a traveling supervisor. Blanche, who has taken a fancy for Mitch, tells Stella that he seems superior to the others. After a moment, Stanley becomes angry with Stella and Blanche for disturbing their game with their noise. He asks them to go upstairs. Stella retorts, saying that it is her home and she will talk as much as she wants to. Blanche advises Stella not to start a row with Stanley, that is fight with Stanley. Stella tells Blanche that Stanley is off drunk, and when Stella is in the bathroom, Blanche turns on radio kept in the room. And a type of music comes over the radio. Stanley takes exception to this and he angrily turns off the radio despite Steve's entreaty to let the girls have their music on the radio. He shouts at Mitch for looking through curtains and admonishes his friends either to play seriously or better to quit the play. Mitch wants to quit, but Pablo pulls the legs of Mitch, and Steve and Stanley also join in. Mitch laughs uncomfortably and continues to look Blanche through the curtains on the kitchen door. Now the conversation between Blanche and Mitch. Mitch then just steps inside the bedroom and he is greeted by Blanche. And Blanche asks him for a cigarette. When Mitch takes out the cigarette from his pretty cigarette case, Blanche notices an inscription on it and asks for an explanation from Mitch. Mitch then explains Blanche that it is a fond reminder of his broken romance from his fiance as she is dead. This leads them to discuss love more intimately, and they come to know more about each other through a series of mutual inquiries and exchange of information. Blanche makes quite an impression on Mitch by her conversation with him. She explains the meaning of her name and their French ancestry. Mitch is relieved to learn that Blanche is still not married. Stanley becomes angry with Mitch for hobnobbing with his sister-in-law and shouts at him to come back. While as she is talking to Mitch, Blanche once again turns on the radio. And she begins to dance, keeping time to the radio music with romantic gestures. Mitch is delighted and moves in awkward imitation like a dancing bear. Stanley rushes into the room and fiercely and picks up the radio and tosses it out of the window, swearing oaths. When Stella condemns the unruly conduct of her husband and asks all the players to quit her house in the name of decency, Stanley becomes enraged and gives a blow to Stella, and there is a regular turmoil now, and men try to restrain Stanley. Blanche is unable to reconcile to the violence of Stanley on her sister Stella, who is going to have her baby soon. Annoyed with Stanley's savage act, she calls him a lunatic. The men then put Stanley under the shower to bring him back to his senses. Stanley, however, keeps struggling with them. Mitch says that poker should not be played in a house with women. Hurt beyond measure, Stella wants to go away from Stanley, and she is escorted upstairs to Eunice by Blanche in order to keep her out of Stanley's reach. A little later, Stanley comes back to his senses and realizes the hell that he has let loose on account of his drunkenness. On realizing that Stella has left him by going to Eunice upstairs, he breaks into sobs. Then he rings up to Eunice, telling her to send his darling Stella back. Finding no response from Eunice, he hurls the phone to the floor and standing on the pavement and begins to say Stella's name repeatedly. Eunice retorts roughly, saying that Stella will not come, and if he shouts any further, she will report to the police against him. But Stanley does not relent and says that he will not return without Stella. Eunice angrily slams the door on him, calling him names, "You stinker, you whelp of your Pollock," undaunted, and Stanley bellows the name of Stella with heaven-splitting violence. At this, Stella comes down to her husband with tears in her eyes, and after a moment they embrace each other. And Blanche comes out on the upper landing in a robe and comes down to her sister's flat. She asks where her little sister Stella is. She soon meets Mitch, who appears from around the corner. She expresses her surprise that Stella's reconciliation with Stanley after what has happened. She is afraid that no harm should befall on Stella. Mitch assures her that there is absolutely nothing to be scared of, for Stella and Stanley are crazy about each other. Blanche says that she is not used to such kinds of patch-ups. When Blanche expresses her concern about the violence that she has witnessed from Stanley, Mitch asks her not to take it seriously. She thanks much for being so kind, while there is so much confusion in this world. So from this scene, there are two important situations. One is the quarrel between Stanley and Stella, and the other is the beginning of an intimacy between Mitch and Blanche. So overall in this scene, Blanche is very much upset by Stanley's boorish behavior in beating Stella, who is pregnant. She escorts her safely to Eunice's apartment upstairs, but later when Stanley begs Stella to return to him, she thinks that Stella will resist it. So when Stella goes after her husband as if nothing had happened between them, she feels that Stella must have gone mad. She is surprised to learn that that Stanley and Stella are devoted to each other, and she need no fear about the safety of her sister. This experience causes a cultural shock in Blanche. Besides, we also come to know of Blanche's vanity, her concern for her looks, and her addiction to drinks. So scene 3 over. So in this session, we have seen two scenes from the story A Streetcar Named Desire, and remaining scenes we will discuss in the next session. Thank you.